shots be crazy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente. Yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella bella. Le busco todo. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino camp.
Yeah, I can't get enough of your love. Give me some more of it. I can't get enough.
Come on.
Yeah. 'Cause I can't get crazy. I like that. You like that. So let's be crazy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, yeah. Ooh, no one's gotta know, we can keep it low-key. I'll be fine alone, long as you're alone with me.
Tell him.
So
Marcus Aldridge. once again, your San Antonio Spurs.
And we've been waiting for this day for a long time. It's opening day in the NBA. Thanks, everyone, for joining us here in the start of a new season. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Brent Beery. David Aldridge will join us momentarily from the sidelines. DA, it's all yours.
Well, guys, the retirements of Tim Duncan, Manu Ginobili, and Tony Parker mean the start of a new era for the Spurs. Guard Patty Mills said, "We've had great teachers, and now there's a transition. It's about teaching that culture to these new guys. We aren't going to change. Bridging the gap is going to take time. That's where leadership comes in." Kevin?
A proud franchise. Thank you, David. Missing some depth tonight, but the starting lineup is intact for this team.
And with Taj Gibson.
So the New York starting five. It's Randall and Robinson at the four and the five. Barrett is out there with Dennis Smith. And it's Morris in at the small forward. And for San Antonio, it's Aldridge at the power forward with Poeltl at center. Then there's Murray. Then it's DeRozan. And it's Forbes in at the shooting guard. Opening night, Brent, always exciting. Technically, every team is undefeated with a lot of hope.
You're just fired up. I mean,
I am fired up.
The NBA never stops, Kevin. We know this, right?
Isn't it great, though? I'm so glad it doesn't stop.
The offseason is just absolutely ridiculously exciting.
So fun.
So much movement and hope for franchises that, have struggled for a long time. And here we go. Hope springs eternal. It's opening night.
Last game for the Spurs. They pick up the W against Memphis. Smith the pass to Robinson. Wants to get it to Randall and does. And Randall throws it down.
And something about watching lefties who can get up like that just looks different, doesn't it, Kevin?
Here's Murray. No good off the back of the rim. Here's New York. Here, matched up against San Antonio, is how they'll tip off the new season.
It's an East versus West matchup tonight. First meeting of the year between these two.
Yeah, fun to see maybe strangers because you just aren't familiar with these faces here tonight. This will be a very exciting game to watch.
Now, here's Barrett. Oh, he's going up for the alley-oop here, and Robinson throws it down.
And you see the passing instincts Barrett has. Great at recognition out on the floor.
And it's DeRozan missing.
Kev, I know it's early, but going 0-for-4 to start a game can make a team get a little bit tight.
Smith kicks to Morris. Trying to get open is Randall. New York now working with a new shot clock. And there are the Knicks with another bucket.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Spurs have gone 0-4, missing their first four field goals here. Here's DeRozan. Good, and the assist goes to Murray.
And boy, did they need that one. Their first make in the five field goal attempts they've had.
Barrett dishes to Smith. New York moving it around. And the wide-open shot from Morris. And it's off from three-point range. Here's Murray. And he uses the glass on the layup.
And when Poeltl sees one of his guys wide open, he whips it his way. He's all for doing what's best for the team.
Now, here is Smith. 9 points last game. A three ball. Good on the triple.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Spurs have gone 2-6 from the field. Aldridge drives in, and that one, good.
Well, some of the advanced statistics bear this out. Aldridge is actually more efficient after a dribble than he is from the standstill.
Looking at the Knicks, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Pelicans. Tipped away. To the middle. Here's Randall, and Randall throws it down.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was short, but the slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
And the guard, Bryn Forbes, won back-to-back state championships as a high schooler in the state of Michigan. A couple years at Cleveland State, then transferred back to the state of Michigan and played at Michigan State.
And after that time at Michigan State, he went undrafted, but Kevin really has developed into a steady rotation player in the NBA. And by the way, quite a knockdown shooter.
Mind the lane. One shot.
That's good from Forbes. The Knicks leading by four. To the inside, Barrett. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
That's an easy shot provided by Dennis Smith Jr.
Here's DeRozan, and he makes that one. DeRozan's got his second basket of the night.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
Are you asking me, G.A.? I'm not sure.
Now, here is Morris. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And Robinson wide open. He shoots. The offensive rebound. And Poeltl sends it back.
And you got to give appreciation to how Poeltl punishes shooters. A dynamite shot blocker with impeccable timing.
Smith wide open. He fires. Here's Barrett. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the defense.
The Knicks shooting their first free throws here tonight.
And their free throw percentage as a unit last year, 76%, right around the middle of the road.
And that one falls for Barrett. And for a lot of these kids, Greg, it's interesting how quickly teams expect them to get up to speed. Case in point, R.J. Barrett.
Yeah, I mean, he had only the 1 year of college, already being asked to produce. Fortunately, he's very mature for his age and generally plays up to the level of competition.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. And Greg, talking to scouts about R.J. Barrett, they love the athleticism. But what makes him especially good is the work ethic and the confidence.
Yeah, some elite prospects will take plays off. This guy never does. He's not one that sits around and reads his press clippings. He's a warrior, a leader, and he's proven to be a winner.
Randall, no good.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
And DeRozan throws it down hard.
And he just glides to the hoop on his drives. DeRozan's got plenty of force to his game, don't get me wrong, but he makes everything look so effortless.
And here are the Knicks now, following the bucket by the Spurs. And here's Morris for three. That's in for the first basket of the game after three attempts.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
It's DeRozan with the drive. And finished off by DeRozan.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. Now, here's Barrett. Now Smith. Pass to Barrett. Just five on the clock. And again, New York with the triple.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooters.
And DeRozan, here we go. Excellent D that time from Robinson. And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for the New York Knicks. 6-point game. Morris with the bucket.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
And the dunk by Aldridge.
Yeah, if he gets enough space, LaMarcus Aldridge will get up and remind you that he's a big man that has mean intentions.
New York's gone 4-7 from three-point range so far in the first. The pass to Robinson. Pass to Randall. And Poeltl sends it back. And here we go. Fast break. Murray's got it. An easy 2 points on the layup. Murray's got six.
Well, that basket must be widening out right now, Kevin. He's making almost every shot he's putting up this quarter.
Smith the pass to Randall. Count it. Good.
This quarter belongs to him. And that's how you do it when you're out in front. Don't play it safe. Keep that momentum going.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. There's a lot of talk, Brent, about eliminating divisions, something that's been discussed. I don't think that's going to happen.
I don't understand what the divisions are, do you?
We don't pay attention to the divisions.
We don't pay any attention to the divisions.
It's all about conference.
And we know that divisions end up helping in some ways with the playoff seedings, but it just seems strange today to have the divisions the way they are divided up. I think it helps when you're opening up a fish wrap in the morning if you check a traditional newspaper, but otherwise... that could be something that goes away soon.
Different look now for San Antonio. Rudy Gay's checked in for Jakob Poeltl. Bellinelli comes in for Brent Forbes. And Derek White subbed in for DeJounte Murray. Knox, he's checked in for the Knicks. And the basket is good. Got it to go through on the contact, so a free throw coming up. A great opportunity for a three-point play. A 29th pick in 2017 by the Spurs. Their injuries last year created an opportunity for Derek White to show Greg what he can do with steady minutes.
And White at 6'4", capable of manning either guard spot, a shooter, a playmaker, and an all-defensive team in college, he is definitely a keeper.
Here's Smith. Passes it to Knox. On the wing, Morris. Six to shoot. Fires from deep. Bellinelli pulls it in.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys. They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Pass to Smith. And the dunk by Smith.
Dennis Smith Jr. getting up on the rim is a highlight everybody here loves to see.
Here's Gay. Here's DeRozan. Gets it to drop, and now he's shooting at a 5-for-8 clip.
Feels like the other four guys have disappeared at this point. He wants to be the one to get them back.
Randle outside. Back to Smith. Feeds to Barrett. And there's the 3-second call, this one on the defense.
Well, the Knicks had a lot of turnover trading for expiring contracts. They did what they could to accommodate the wishes of a lot of vets.
Yeah, the problem right now for the Knicks is they're not inviting to a lot of free agents, and that's really where they're trying to make their play. So fascinating over the course of the past decade that New York has not been able to attract the top-tier talent. So building through the draft, Coach Fizdale hopeful that they'll land a star one way or another.
And a breakthrough season for Marcus Morris in 2018 and 19. Career highs almost across the board.
Looking at who's out there now for the Knicks. Bobby Portis has checked in for Julius Randle. Damian Dotson comes in for Barrett. And it's Peyton in for Dennis Smith. Now, here's Portis. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against New Orleans. You know, Greg, the Celtics are encouraging their players to take mental health just as seriously as their physical health. Marcus Morris, brave enough to say that helped him a lot.
I mean, the Morris twins growing up in the hard streets of Philly. I mean, a lot to overcome, but by getting some help, that's exactly what Marcus is doing.
Good!
That's too easy. A player of Rudy Gay's scoring prowess, he's salivating on shots like that.
Out to the right wing, and a wide open look for Portis. His three-pointer's off the mark.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
And that one's goodbye, Gay.
Adept at converting at the mid-range, Rudy Gay, when he gets room to shoot, he's not going to think about it two times.
Payton passes to Knox. And looks like the illegal kick was set. Yep, that's right. That'll get their attention.
That's going to draw a whistle every time down the floor. Not even close to being a legal screen.
Yeah, everybody saw that one. That was pretty blatant there.
Wayne Ellington's checked in for New York. Here's White. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead there. The Knicks with the lead. Payton with the ball. Now the pass to Dotson. Here's Knox, and the layup is good. Knox has got five.
Well, Knox finding his way around the rim and then pretty versatile to finish.
Pass to DeRozan. And there's the defensive 3-second call.
Well, it was a season of rebuilding, and Damian Dotson was certainly a bright spot for the Knicks, a guy that just loves to let it fly, and he found his way into some minutes after some roster turnover. It made the best of his chances for Coach Fizdale.
And so he hits the technical free throw. And for Dotson, Brent, it's not always easy for second-round picks to find the chance to increase their role.
Yeah, you wonder, Kevin, if being a second-round pick isn't the thing we should be talking about. It's about Dotson spending 4 years in college and coming in with a more mature perspective so that when the opportunity arose for him to take advantage, he would do so. Looks like he's found a spot in the league.
Now, here's Ellington. 11 points for him in that last game against New Orleans. Here's Gay. Great touch on the 16-footer. Gay's got his third bucket of the night.
And they've worked the ball around so well tonight for those quality looks from mid-range.
Some nice passing by New York here. Dotson gets the bucket. And the Knicks lead by four.
Pretty sweet pass there as Knox showing his ability to read the floor.
Payton against Gay. Payton passes to Portis. Good work defensively by Gay. So it's San Antonio now. And the jam by Rudy Gay.
Rudy Gay up off the ground and dunking it down hard. Nice to see that.
One thing we've seen from these guys is excellent passing.
No doubt about it. It's fun to watch the way they're operating as a team right now. They are all in sync.
Knox. Offline with his three. On offense, here are the Spurs. Trailing by two. Passes it to Bellinelli. And another basket for San Antonio.
So far, both teams scorching the Nets. You gotta love it.
Yeah, made for TV game here. Pace is great. Scoring is coming in bunches. And both of the teams feeling confident right now.
Now, here's Portis. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. New York, no good that time either. This offense has really been clicking.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with. And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Out to the right wing. Here's Dotson. A three-pointer, no good. And here are the Spurs. They're on a 13-5 run here. And here's the fast break. Shots good by Lyles.
Beautiful transition offense there. That's execution at its best.
Yeah, once you burst through a seam like that, you got to look right towards the rim. Sweet play.
Now here's Payton. 6-second difference between the shot and game clock. No good on the three. Spurs leading by four. To the paint. And the jam by Rudy Gay.
And for a power forward, he can sure get up. I mean, because of that leaping ability, it kind of offsets his height disadvantage.
Payton outside. 1 second left. No good on the last second attempt there. And so it's the San Antonio Spurs with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. They're playing a cruising game inside, and it's working for them. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And in 2018, DeMar DeRozan opened up about his battles with depression, hoping to have a positive impact on others.
A lot of people shame to talk about it. Even myself, for a long period of time, people wonder why I was such a quiet guy. And that was part of it, not wanting to speak out about it, not wanting other people know exactly what I was going through. But you get to a certain age where you feel like it's all about helping others. It's not about you just being a selfish person about the things you're going through, other people going through stuff as well.
Yep, you love the honesty and the bravery to step forward and tell his emotional story.
Yeah, he opened a dialogue, Kevin Love following his lead to talk about anxiety. Athletes, as public figures, can have a broader impact than just entertaining, and we see it over and over again.
And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And taking a look at San Antonio's performance here, what do you think they've been doing or not doing?
Well, in that first quarter, they were intent on just pounding the ball down low.
Yeah, you don't see that all that often, getting down there and doing that much damage in a quarter. You got to respect the game plan.
Hill's at point with Bellinelli. They're the backcourt. Jamari Carroll is out there with Rudy Gay, and it's Lyles in at the center, locking down the middle. So that's who San Antonio starts the second with. Payton gets the bucket.
A soft touch from Elfrid Payton. A little tricky there with the floater.
Here's Mills. The Knicks pull it in. They'll be off to Brooklyn for a meeting with the Nets after this one. That will conclude their brief two-game road trip. No one near Payton as he lets it go. No good from outside.
Looks like the game plan is they're willing to give him that kind of shot. It worked out for them this time, but if they give it to him again, I bet 3 points are coming, Kevin.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, we all know that circumstances and time changes everything. In Dallas, Dennis Smith Jr. thought he was going to be the cornerstone. But with the arrival of Luka Doncic, everything changed. The promising point guard was traded to the Knicks, and Smith said it was important. It's a big opportunity, and I've just got to make the most of it. Kevin, we know one thing. In New York, the ball is back in Smith's hands.
And D.A., that's when he is at his best. Thank you. Knicks trail by 8. 2 minutes now played in the second quarter. In the corner, Knox with it. Rebound, San Antonio. Lyles got rebound number 5 here tonight.
Maybe there are ways to contribute that don't involve shooting the basketball. That's the best way that maybe he can help them out in trying to win this game.
New York's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Payton passes to Trier. Teardrop shot, and it's laid in by Payton. Payton's got 6 here in this quarter.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
And it's blocked, and he recovers it. Shot's good by Mills.
There he is, beasting on the glass, converting the opportunity, trying to put this game away.
I just don't see how you climb back into the game when you're allowing plays like that to happen. Extra work on the offensive glass.
Here's Trier following the bucket by the Spurs. Good work there as it goes.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Shoots from 12. Shots good by Lyles. Lyles got the lead up to 10 now for San Antonio.
That's exactly the shot they're looking for.
The Knicks have gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. And so New York calls timeout. They're first. Greg, you suited up for 6 teams in your NBA career. What do you think about some of the front offices that you came across during that playing time?
I think when you find a front office, when you move from franchise to franchise, is what it is that they value most. And there were some franchises, quite frankly, Kevin, that I played for where they just wanted you to show up on time, get there, play the game, and leave. Those franchises end up having a lot of struggle to find some footing in the league. They also find trouble finding attraction from free agency because people understand the culture just isn't there. There are other teams that do so many other things well, Kevin. You feel so much more valued as a player throughout your course of your career. Those are the places that end up sticking with you. And I think the league is doing a great job from top to bottom, moving in that direction. Now, some are doing it better than others. That will always be the case. But the idea around finding more completeness for what it is you provide a player is a great thing for everybody.
And some changes here for the Spurs. Pirtle, he's checked in for Game. Bryn Forbes comes in for Marco Bellinelli. And Murray's subbed in for Patty Mills. So New York going with almost an entire new group here. Robinson's checked in for Bobby Portis. Randall comes in for Kevin Knox. Barrett's checked in for Damian Dotson. And Smith subbed in for Elfrid Payton. Now here's Carroll. Again, the Spurs good for two.
And usually Carroll will stay beyond the arc, that time stepping in for the basket.
Knicks trail by 12. Trier passes to Randall.
And a breakout season for Julius Randle in 2018-19. Averaged close to 20-10, delivering on the talent that saw him taken seventh overall back in 2014.
The Knicks have made three free throws so far. Haven't missed any. The first one falls.
Seventh pick in the 2014 NBA draft. The interesting thing about Randall is he falls into that category as a tweener. Maybe not a three-man or a four-man, but over the course of his career, he's decided to improve his outside shooting, become a threat driving to the basket, and now finding a home offensively in the NBA. You wonder how much further he can go if he could expand to the three-point line. Julius Randle's going to be in this league for a long time.
Here's Forbes. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Murray's got six assists now in the game.
Pushing the action, getting others involved. He does it time and time again.
Nice to play with a point guard that takes pride in playmaking. It makes you move around just a little bit faster to get open spots.
Greg, the Lakers allowed Julius Randle to leave in restricted free agency in 2018 so they could preserve some of their cap space.
I mean, his defense still lags behind, but offensively, well, he is special. The lefty, tough to deal with inside. And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
D has been just completely helpless and turned around. He's so dangerous when he's in this kind of rhythm.
And making his return from the ACL tear, DeJounte Murray, long, athletic, and young. He still has a very bright future.
One shot.
And Murray winning second team all defense in 2018. And Greg, at that time, he was only 21.
And that's been his strong suit. If he can hit perimeter shots consistently, he can be a star.
Now, here's Barrett. 7 points in the game. Smith outside. Connects from three-point range. Smith's got 8 points.
Encouraging to see Dennis Smith Jr. with that kind of range and that kind of confidence.
Here's Murray. That shot off the mark. Some solid defense from Robinson. Barrett the pass to Randall. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. Big man who was forgotten about during free agency, Randall could be an impact player for the Knicks.
And Knicks missed out on the marquee names they were after, but Randall should give them great production for quite some time. Not a huge name, but a young talent that can help this team.
First one falls for him. So he makes one of two as the second one misses. Carroll with the three, buries the long-range jumper. Carroll's got 5 points now this quarter.
Well, he's got that height advantage, and out on the perimeter, a smaller defender is just not going to contest.
And Morris has got the ball here for New York. Randall, it falls for his seventh bucket of the contest. He's 7 for 9.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Nice shot by Poeltl.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Knicks trail by 13. Barrett the pass to Smith. Kicks to Barrett. There's the lob to the hoop. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Here's Carroll. Here's Poeltl. Blanketed by the D, he fights to the rim for the layup. And the Spurs lead by 15.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Here's Robinson. Carroll with the rebound.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Over Randall. And that one goes long. For New York, they've gone 7-13 from the field since the start of the second. With Samark, and it's Barrett getting it to go. Barrett's got 9.
With defenses usually playing him to drive, Barrett's developed a nice little floater for when he can't get to the rim.
Here's Smith, 8 points for him.
And they've gone to the full court press here, looking to make things as difficult as possible and maybe force a turnover or two.
It's good on the putback.
Somebody not alert to block out the wide frame of Julius Randle, who gets in there after the loose ball.
Here's Murray. Here's Poeltl. It's rebounded by New York. Robinson's got 6 rebounds in the game. Here's Morris. There it is, his third basket. He's taken 7 shots to get those 3.
An efficient score inside. Morris can beat you with a variety of moves.
San Antonio calls timeout. Now for San Antonio. LaMarcus Aldridge, he's checked in for Trey Lyles. DeMar DeRozan comes in for Damari Carroll, and it's wide in for Murray. And New York with a change here too. Ellington's checked in. Now here's White. 7 points in the game. Now here's Barrett. Smith left side. fires the three. Barrett, no good.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And
Oh, man. Fans love that. Listen to that. I love that sound in the arena.
He's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Insane dunk.
And now they're starting to rub it in. Build up a lead, and here we go, baby. It is showtime. Now, here is Smith. He's got eight, and Randall throws it down.
Randall getting up there, explosive vertically on that play with great timing.
Here's DeRozan. Again, the Spurs good for two.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Hey, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Aldridge against Randall. Pass to Barrett. Count that as his fourth basket of the night. Just seven shots to get there.
And you like the toughness there. Barrett being more comfortable having to deal with an aggressive defense.
Pulls up from the corner, and the Spurs scoring again. And here's Smith. Here's Randall. And another shot. The shot's good. Randall's got 22 points.
This is not a player who likes to be trailing in any game. That lights a fire.
It's rebounded by Barrett. Knicks trail by 11. Inside. Here's Randall. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's on LaMarcus Aldridge.
Well, Randall can hold his own down on the inside with that physical frame, Kevin.
So far in the game, he's gone 2 for 4 from the free throw line.
Looking back to last season, he was at about 73%.
That free throw good from Randall.
Well, it's interesting to watch him because he's putting his body on the line to get to the line. We didn't see this during the first quarter, but he's making up for it here.
Both free throws good from Randall. Spurs leading by 9. Here's White. Randall grabs the board. Randall's got 7 rebounds in the game. Here's the floater. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Smith's got assist number 7 for him tonight. Down low. The 11-footer. White, good. White's got 9 points.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
Knicks trail by 9. Here's Smith. And the Knicks good for 2.
And Kevin, they started the game shooting it so well. I'm surprised they haven't continued. They've got to get back to their strength.
DeRozan. That's good.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
Yeah, and the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
Now, here is Morris. 9 points in the game so far.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Here's DeRozan, and finished off by DeRozan.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the Knicks. Here's Barrett, and Barrett slams it in.
And you see the edge Barrett plays with, attacking the rim with bad intention.
Here's White. That's good. Basket number 5 on a 5-for-8 night shooting.
And say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
And stolen by Aldridge. Hurdle inside. Ellington defending. Good on the bucket.
And the soft hands of Hurdle on display there. Just has such a nice stroke from the mid-range.
Smith against White. Smith right side. New York moving it around. For three, Ellington. Kept alive by New York. Morris with the bucket.
Terrific score there off the miss by Morris. Doesn't get a ton of offensive rebounds, but making that one count.
White drives in. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken nine shots and missed but three. 15 seconds left in the second quarter. Smith outside. Launches a three. The shot off that time. And so it's DeMar DeRozan making highlights for San Antonio. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Back right after this.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. DeMar DeRozan brought his A game early tonight. He had 18 points and two rebounds. And Shaq, what are your thoughts on how San Antonio played?
Well, Kenny knows about this. I used to do this to his team all the time. Take advantage of you down low. Mismatch. Barbecue chicken alert. Make good entry passes. That led to some good looks. Obviously, a lot of points. When you control the paint, Ernie, you control the game.
I was the master of controlling fine paint. Shaquilicus.
And Kenny, your take on New York.
Percentage-wise, they were in the low 30s. That's right, low 30s from beyond the arc. That won't get it done. Every team in the league now relies on some level of consistent production from the three-point line. But if you dunk yourself a hole and you aren't a three-point shooting team, that needs to change.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks. Thanks goodbye, for folks. Joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. We're seeing a tremendous game from Julius Randle.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. On the court for the Knicks, it's Randle and Robinson at the four and the five. Smith is out there with Barrett. And it's Morris in at the three, the small forward. The Spurs have hit all four of their chances so far in this one. Now Smith. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Kevin, before he became a head coach in Memphis and New York, David Fizdale spent eight seasons as an assistant under Eric Spoelstra in Miami. Now Spo said he's a brilliant basketball mind that has exceptional gold standard level communication skills. One of the most talented coaches I've been around. So Kevin, Fizdale is highly respected.
David, he sure is. Great reputation. Now getting his shot. Thank you so much.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
And how about that? Coming out to start the half, a perfect 3 of 3.
It's common to see wing players improve their perimeter shooting in the league, but DeMar DeRozan's most striking growth has been his ball handling and playmaking. He's been dynamic with the ball in his hands.
That's good from DeMar DeRozan. And Greg DeRozan watching a ton of films of guys like Andre Miller and Sam Cassell operating in the pick and roll.
Not only that, Kevin, to strengthen his left hand, he'd use it for daily activities like writing, leaving no stone unturned to become an expert initiator.
For New York, they have gone 7 of 9 from the free throw line tonight.
A guy who's bounced around the league a little. Surprising, given that Morris is a solid shooter and a pretty good defender and rebounder.
Here's Randall. Here's Barrett. New York, no good that time either.
And they start the second half with three straight misses.
And the Spurs scoring again.
And everything is dropping for them. Terrific second half run.
Well, with the confidence growing, that's one thing. But they seem to be getting more intense, and that's helping the quality of their play here.
And Smith with the stuff.
All about the burst there. Dennis Smith Jr. creating the separation.
Here's Murray. The Knicks pull it in.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough. The team starts the second half missing 4 of 5 shots. When does the coach possibly call a timeout and reiterate what he talked about at halftime?
Smith in the post. He's covered by Murray. And Smith with the stuff.
I mean, he got to know that he can get up just like that. Wow.
And Murray, here we go. And the Spurs scoring again.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Knicks trail by 20. Smith for three. It's good from long range. Smith's got 17.
Well, defense has to start paying some respect to Smith Jr.'s ability to knock it down.
San Antonio calls timeout. And you spend any amount of time watching Dennis Smith Jr., Greg, his leaping ability makes for some impressive highlights.
Kevin, he's got the size and the off-the-charts athleticism. Now just trying to figure out how to realize his obvious potential.
Checked in for Bryn Forbes. And New York with a change here, too. Knox has checked in. Spurs leading by 17. Here's Murray. And some very quick points for him on that possession. He's got 16.
And this is how you want to come out of the half. Prolific and efficient.
Well, the thing is, they're controlling the pace right now. And if that was the mantra for them at halftime, they've carried it out.
And it's Mills with the ball for the San Antonio Spurs. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. And that's the third of four straight played at home.
And you want to talk about high-volume scores? Just look at what DeRozan's doing tonight. He's been on a mission, putting his mark on this game in a big way.
And the pass to Knox shoots over DeRozan. Mills with the rebound.
Well, he wants to shoot his way out of this cold spell, but the struggles continue.
Yeah, he's got to move on, forget about this sequence here, and try to find a way to get on the board. And kind of par for the course here, right? Coming through with a solid offensive game to help them get this lead.
New York calls timeout. The 55th pick back in 2009. Those picks don't hit very often, but Greg Patty Mills, now with a decade in the NBA.
6 foot nothing. And that may be generous. The Australian, Mills, a dangerous pull-up shooter, and he does not back down.
Peyton, he's checked in for New York.
And checking out the numbers for Robinson, how he performed last season. Last year averaged 7 points a game, almost 2.5 blocks and 6 rebounds. And he's done his share of the work for the team, definitely making an impact.
Well, the numbers, if you look at them, impressive all the way around, and he's not letting the team down.
Pass to Peyton. Back to Knox. All alone. That's good. And it's Peyton with the assist. Knox has got 7 points.
Like it when you fire it to a teammate who's ready to shoot, and Kevin Knox was.
We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Passes to Robinson. The feed now to Randall. And Randall throws it down.
Now Randall is looking like tonight he's capable of taking on the whole offensive load.
And DeRozan kicks to Aldridge. Banked in off the glass. He's got 8.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
Knicks trail by 21, and Randall throws it down.
You risk getting torched when somebody's open. Peyton's skilled enough to find the open man.
Aldridge finds Murray over Peyton. Murray, no good. New York's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Knox. They grab their own miss. And Pirtle sends it back. Here's Mills. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
And Patty's just so aggressive out there on the floor and forces the defense's hand, constantly looking to get either contact or get himself to the free throw line.
San Antonio shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight.
And take a look back at last season and what a season it was for them from the free throw line. 82% as a group.
First free throw is good. Last year, the average salary for a starting point guard, Brent, in the NBA was the highest among all positions. Why would that be?
Well, with the way the game has changed, Kevin, there's certainly an emphasis on being able to find guys who are initiating offense, scoring the basketball, shooting three-pointers, and you're seeing a big shift in salaries between point guards and bigs. That's where the biggest disparity is. Centers in the league are getting less and less of an opportunity to have the extended big money contracts because the game has moved to the perimeter. And if you're a big that cannot play on the perimeter, there's not a lot of teams that are willing to invest a significant amount of their cap space into the center position. They want guards and wings who can play out there and do the damage from there.
And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. It's on LaMarcus Aldridge. And the former Razorback, Bobby Portis, took a few years to find his spot in the NBA. But now he does produce.
And great big man to bring in off the bench. Good size and quickness combination, and will always give you scoring with that second unit.
Take a break. 2 shots.
And the first one drops. So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Trey Lyles checked in for Purdy. Gay comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Damari Carroll's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Bellinelli in for Murray. And the Knicks making a change here as well. Dotson's checked in for Mitchell Robinson. Good on both. Spurs leading by 17. Here's Mills. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet. Mills has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, some body control shown by Mills slamming on the brakes and pulling up for a soft J.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
Here's Trier. Fires for three. Knocks down the three ball. Trier's got five now.
The D just sagged off just enough and no hesitation on his part.
Got that bucket in no time at all. And the Spurs lead by 20.
Well, there's a couple things that Patty is working on to be a better player in this league, and finding the open man is one of them.
And here are the Knicks now after the basket by San Antonio. Here's Lyles. And that one hits back iron.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Here's Portis. Bellinelli pulls it in.
Yeah, that miss might stick with him for a little while. That's kind of a shoot-around jumper if I've ever seen one.
And that one's good by Gay.
There's been nights like this throughout Rudy Gay's career. He's back on one now.
Knicks trail by 20. Here's Trier. He has seven. Pass to Portis. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
And taking a look back at his performance at the line a year ago, a rock solid 79%.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
Whitey's checked in for the Spurs. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. Spurs leading by 18. There's the pass to Lyles. Takes the elbow jumper and trains it. Lyles got 10 points in the game.
And they are earning points with the jump shot now.
Nice shot by Portis.
Now, Peyton's very good at getting the ball to his guys, and he makes a good decision there.
And San Antonio shooting a magnificent 69% in this game. White, good.
Impressive, really, from that short 17 area. They are not missing many.
Knicks trail by 20. Here's Trier.
Oh, that was huge!
Incredible. Oh, he's putting on a show for these fans.
I can't believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play. Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see them get up like that. And there are only a few players in the league who can hit a teammate like that in stride. Beautiful assist.
And the basket is good. 8 points for Elfrid Payton.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range. And we're seeing some great ball movement out of this group, guys.
Here's Trier. 9 points in the game so far. Payton with the ball. And there's the foul. It's on Trey Lyles. And that'll be his third foul so far. Spurs making a switch here. Forbes checked in. And the Knicks making a change here as well. Wayne Ellington's checked in for Damian Dotson. Now here's Ellington, Carroll covering. Clock at six. New York needs to get off a shot. Here's Trier. That shot, no good. And it's the Spurs taking it the other way. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead. And he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
And the athleticism, always been NBA caliber. Carroll showing it off there with the finish.
Here's Payton. Sweet little floater. Payton's got 4 points now in the quarter.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
And that's a foul. It's called on Wayne Ellington. That's his first foul. The Knicks making a switch here. Morris is checked in. Here's Gay. Sinks that one from the post. Gay's got 18 points.
Moving it around. 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
Here's Knox. And that one is stuffed right through.
Just way too easy as Kevin Knox rises up for the dunk.
Here's Gay. And the Spurs scoring again.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Knicks trail by 20. Now here's Payton. He's got 10. And the basket by Knox. He's got 11.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
It's stolen by Morris. Here's Knox. He's covered by Gay. Gay with the defensive effort.
He creates such a great opportunity right at the rim, and he just can't get it to go. Even with the defense, not really a factor.
How about the purpose with which he's crashing the backboards right now? Some hard-earned second-chance points.
Here's Portis, and Portis throws it down.
Yes, sir. And a long windup and strong follow-through on the one-hand jam.
Yeah, he's not going to mess that one up.
And really just led him to his sweet spot for that finish.
1:39 left to play in the third. Knicks trail by 20. Ellington kicks to Payton. To the middle. Nice shot by Portis.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead.
And so White will bring it up for San Antonio. The shot by Carroll, no good. Here's Knox. Plays it up and banks it in. Knox has got 8 here in the quarter.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside, and that's 10 points in a row in the paint.
No good from Gay. New York's gone into the three-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. That one good for 2.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Now here's White. 17 points in the game, and there it is for him.
And yeah, he's not messing around. He wants no part of a comeback in this one.
Well, he's grabbed a tee and a blanket because he's putting this one to bed.
A different look now for San Antonio. Aldridge comes in for Lyles. And DeMar DeRozan subbed in for Damari Carroll. Smith checked in for New York. There's 42 seconds left here in the third quarter. Pass to Knox. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
A power flush with a long hang on the rim at the end of that.
That could be a catalyst for him. It really could. Count the basket. 10 points for Aldridge.
Well, he's been around the block a few years. Aldridge added that J a few seasons ago, has stuck with it, a big part of his staple.
Now, here is Smith, 17 points in the game. DeRozan surveying the D. The Knicks pull it in. Ellington's got 4 rebounds in this game. Smith. And the foul called on Marcus Morris. That'll be his second foul of the game. So both teams making some changes here. 9 seconds left to play here in the third. Here's Aldridge. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Murray's got 9 assists now tonight.
Well, back to the basket. Sometimes more facing up is Aldridge. He excels right there down in the painted area.
Playing from behind right here. Not easy, but he is answering the bell.
Yeah, doing anything he can right now to get his team to cut into this lead and give them a chance.
And so it's DeMar DeRozan making highlights for San Antonio. He has been a determined scorer today. 29 points altogether for him. And I think there's more where that came from. We've got more in store for you right after this. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
That's what great passing will do for you right there, dissecting the defense with that play.
And 1 quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. Knicks trail by 14. Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. On the floor for San Antonio, Gay and Aldridge are up front. Derek White is out there with DeJounte Murray. And it's DeRozan in at the three slot. Now here's Murray. Following the missed shot by Dennis Smith. Yep, it counts.
Well, a pretty decent distributor at his position. Rudy's good at getting rid of the ball that time.
The Knicks shooting has been beyond great up until now. How about 57% from the field overall? Smith for three. Drills it from outside. Smith's got 12 points in just the second half.
Well, he now has 4 3-pointers this game, guys. 2 in each half. He's really spacing out the floor for his teammates.
Total letdown by the D. Can't leave the bucket unprotected.
Absolutely. And it attacks an easy 2 points onto the lead.
Will not find a higher percentage opportunity than that.
Now, here is Smith. He lobs up the alley-oop pass, and Robinson throws it down.
And maybe that'll trigger them. Impossible not to get pumped up after that.
Yeah, well, you could see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are pumped up.
Few more points there for Aldridge, getting consistency around that rim. A career average of 20 points per game. He's going to get you.
Here's Barrett following the basket by LaMarcus Aldridge to the inside. It's good, and the San Antonio lead is kept back down to 13 points, and that one coming from Robinson.
Now they're playing working to perfection there, if that was their plan. And if it wasn't, maybe that should be their plan.
Well, he's been doing it all night. Why not go back to it?
Yeah, he's feeling it. Keep feeding him until he misses.
Pirtle, he's checked in for San Antonio. Mills comes in for White. That's good from DeMar DeRozan.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for New York. Pass to Randall. Back to Smith. Now, here's Barrett. He's tightly guarded. Randall with the bucket.
Well, the rest of the team has looked pretty bad tonight, but he's done a fantastic job of scoring the ball and carrying the load on offense.
And it's out of bounds. The Knicks will take it the other way. Knicks trail by 14. It's Robinson high post. Plays it up and in off the pretty assist. Robinson's got 6 in the quarter.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
You have to recognize the importance of spacing out there on the floor. So when Aldridge gets a good look like that one from deep, he's going to take it.
Bucket is good.
He's not the reason that they're trailing in this one. He's been on his game It's a few of the other guys that need to pick it up.
Murray, good. The Knicks have gotten it done so far from the field here in the fourth, going 6-for-7. Smith for three. And Poeltl pulls it down. Poeltl's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. Oh, and the jam by DeRozan.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with two hands on that stuff. And here's Barrett. Now Smith. He kicks to Barrett. To the paint. Here's Randall. Battles through traffic and lays it in. Randall's got 38 points.
Yeah, Randall does a good job. His frame alone helps to create some space. Just with a little pivot there, able to find a way to score.
Knicks trail by 15. The drive by Smith. Pass to Barrett. And here's Smith, covered by Mills. New York moving it around. A three from Morris. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. And that's 17 points for Marcus Morris. San Antonio calls timeout.
You know, Kevin, can Dennis Smith Jr. not rely on just trying to be explosive all the time? Can he play with some poise and patience and get the in-between game going to help this offense do what it needs to do to function efficiently? That is the task at hand for Dennis Smith Jr. as he plays for the New York Knicks this season.
Let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
During that break, Greg Popovich really had some strong advice for his team. His demeanor was not one of a coach whose team was well ahead. He said, this is the time to turn up the heat, make one final push, and try to close out strong. We'll see if they were listening, guys.
And Brent, you and I were just talking about this with Smith. He's learning to pass out of or turn to a floater more often on his drive.
Yeah, that's because he used to be able to, because of his athleticism and playing against lesser talent, burst by guys and have no obstruction. Well, in the NBA, it doesn't quite work that way. You've got to find ways to, once you get into the gaps, have decisions at the ready, whether that's to score or make plays for your teammates. That's where Dennis Smith Jr. has to improve.
And wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
Yeah, but look at the basket guy still shaking.
Just a late reaction there from the defense, and he is always going to finish that one.
Knicks trail by 12. Goes up to the stripe. Here's Robinson, and there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. That gives him a double-double in this one. 10 points and 12 rebounds. Here's Mills. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Well, he lacks some size and some strength, but Mills creative in the inside to finish that one. That's his third.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for New York. Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. You gotta like what DeMar DeRozan has done in this game.
Yeah, smart move here. Talk things over. He's really eating them up, and they've tried a few different looks defensively. Nothing quite getting it done.
He's checked in for Patty Mills. Inside, and the shot is good. The Spurs lead has been cut to just 11 on the basket from Barrett.
Making plays in traffic. This is where Barrett's most effective.
Aldridge, no luck. New York's gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. Back to Randall. Fades. They get it back. And the lead is down inside single digits. Randall's got 44.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring them back.
Of all the action happening there, Kevin, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
An intentional foul committed, but for what purpose, Greg? I'm not sure.
A scene of confusion right there. I can't imagine why he thought it was a good idea to foul there.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over.
And in a league that's obsessed with threes and layups, DeMarcus Aldridge defying the trend, really feasting on a steady diet of mid-range jumpers.
Knicks trail by 11. And that turnaround jumper of Aldridge's. Greg, just impossible to defend.
Long arms, that high release point. When it's falling, well, we saw him give OKC 56. This man can take over.
Pretty easy right now. Clear out, give him some space, let him get to work.
Smith for three. Rebound, San Antonio. Aldridge has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. And it's out of bounds. The Knicks will take it the other way. New York's gone 2-5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. Here's Smith. No stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a three-point play. That one on Jakob Poeltl.
One shot.
And that one misses.
A ninth pick in the 2017 NBA draft. Smith Jr. made the NBA's all-rookie team after a very solid first year in Dallas, averaging 15 points and 5 assists. And he sure is not looking to stop there.
Here's Smith, following the score by DeMar DeRozan. Smith right side. And Poeltl pulls it down. Poeltl's got rebound number 12 here already in the game. Here's DeRozan, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
At the line for your Spurs, DeMar DeRozan, taking two shots.
First free throw is good. Kevin Knox has checked in for Marcus Morris. DeMar DeRozan hits them both.
I felt like he was a little hesitant in the first half, but really he's amping himself up here and battering around to get himself to the free throw line.
Now here is Smith. They get it again. Barrett. And Pirtle sends it back.
On the wing, DeRozan.
At the line for your Spurs, DeMar DeRozan. Two shots.
And that free throw good from DeRozan. Both free throws good from DeRozan. Here's Barrett. It's Robinson, top of the key. Here's Knox. From outside, off the mark.
Well, if he wants to make the defense work, he's got to start knocking down the threes. Only one so far in this game for him, and none since halftime.
Now, here is Smith. Barrett, no good.
Well, he's not very hard to defend right now. This is when the defense might step back. Let him try to find his range.
Count that one. Knicks trail by 18.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Here's Smith. The teardrop falls in. Smith's got 28 points for the game.
Well, that's just Smith Jr. breaking down a defense with the handle and then taking what he sees.
And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Pirtle. Here's Knox. Smith on the wing. Takes a three. Hits it from three-point range. Smith's got a pair of threes here in the fourth quarter for the Knicks.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the three-point line.
Knicks trail by 15. Here's Barrett. And Barrett slams it in.
And with this kind of momentum behind him, Barrett, a terror. Love seeing him hammer it home.
Here's Forbes. And another basket for San Antonio.
You got to get up tighter than that. Some players you can give that much room to, but not him.
New York shooting percentage, 59%. The offense is running smoothly.
Now that's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Here's Knox. He's covered by Murray. Kicks it to Smith. He dishes it to Robinson. Another possession, another assist.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long. Here's Pirtle. Robinson pulls it in. Knicks trail by 11. To the paint, here's Randall. And then Randall slams it in.
Oh, that's nuts. Randall getting up there, turning a little bit, and putting on a bit of a show here.
Here's Forbes. And they cash in right away with a quick shot. Forbes has got four this quarter. 1:56 left in the fourth quarter. And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the Knicks. The pass to Randall. New York moving the ball around. Barrett wide open. He fires. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
Yeah, the man was wide open there, and Julius Randle understood the timing to get him the ball to get that score.
Here's Murray. Knicks with the rebound. Here's Knox. Pass to Robinson. He kicks it to Smith. Misses the three. Spurs leading by eight. It's Aldridge penetrating. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
That's the type of finisher he is. Aldridge takes the contact but still has the strength and touch to drain the shot. We'll see if he can add to it there at the line.
.115 left in the fourth quarter of this one. To the inside. And Randall throws it down.
Now, with Dennis Smith Jr. is dropping those kind of passes, it's going to help the offense just run a bit more smooth.
Forbes. Spurs working now with a new shot clock. Aldridge kicks to Murray. Passes it to Forbes. Five on the clock. From deep. And the foul on Dennis Smith Jr. That will get him his fourth foul of the game, and due to the bonus, we will head to the line for two. San Antonio calls timeout. They're in front by nine. There's 47 seconds left to play in the final quarter.
Handle life all black like a Batman. Dribble too much.
The loudest and craziest fans get a free T-shirt. Like I'm shooting in a trash can.
I'm still balling even if I get a bad pass. Put your name and your ankles on a hashtag. This too easy, it's like shooting on a trash can.
Watch, shoot this boy from running, yeah, I swear I had no punch. She with that, I got dropped before the hell I pop.
And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, DeMar DeRozan.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
He doesn't take over games like this very much, but it's always possible. And when he does, here at home, these fans love it. So the first one drops, and that'll push the lead to double digits. And so Murray nails both of them. There's 47 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Ntilikina. Tries again, and it's good on the way in.
Way to stick with it right there as Ntilikina able to keep it going with the activity.
Murray for three. No good. Now the Knicks take it the other way.
Guys, let's just go ahead and call this one. It's over.
You want to keep expending energy or do you want to start thinking about the next one?
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. That's a two-pointer from Walker, and he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
Impressive job by the players, coaches, and don't discount the impact of these fans.
Awesome to see their output tonight, trying to urge their team on, and that can always help. That home advantage of home fans getting you going, fully on display here.
And so it's San Antonio with the win. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. DeMar, coming off of this long layoff, you guys come back and you don't miss a beat. So how important is it to get a game like this?
It's definitely important. You know, we had a couple days of rest. Well, we need it. You know, we understand we got to come back and try to make a push.
It starts with one step, and that was tonight. Thanks, DeMar. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that'll do it for the first game of the NBA season. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.